The rivers with a sediment load have reached the sea. Here, they will enter a very dynamic environment with bathymetries varying from 0 to more than 10,000 meters, a domain characterized by slow and very rapid water movements, a region where life can be abundant or nearly completely absent. We will look at all these features in the coming slides, always with the overarching goal of understanding the processes to increase the ability to predict the subsurface. This is the bathymetry of the seafloor along a representative transect from the coast to the deep ocean. You can see the coastal regions, the large and flat continental shelf, the relatively steep and narrow continental slope, and eventually the huge and monotonous abyssal plain. A further very important element in the marine system is the photic zone, which is the water column penetrated by light. Here, photosynthesis is possible and small plants can flourish, forming the first ring of the food chain. Underneath the photic zone, waters become dark, cold, and inhospitable. The coastal region is the area of interaction between the sea and the continent. Waves, currents, and tides can erode, transport, and/or deposit sands and other sediments, resulting in a large variety of coastal types. Understanding and predicting such changes is important for geological purposes and is key for responsible management of the highly populated coastal regions. The continental shelf is a flat domain adjacent to the coast, characterized by water depths below 150 to 100 meters. A well-defined shelf edge marks the transition with the continental slope. The width of the shelf changes from region to region and can vary from kilometers to several tens of kilometers or even hundreds of kilometers. In general, shelves associated with passive continental margins, such as the eastern side of the American continent, are much wider than those developed along active margins, such as along the Andes. Continental shelves are the domains of currents and tides, and the fundamental temporary short storage place of sediments between the coast and the abyssal plain. Having passed the shelf margin, the seafloor starts to rapidly deepening, eventually leading to the abyssal plains. This is the continental slope, a tens of kilometers wide region with a slope of less than a few degrees. Nothing spectacular for our eyes of human beings, but of great importance in the marine domain. It is the region bypassed by the sediments which have been deposited on the shelf and then transported down to the abyssal plain. Huge, sediment-loaded currents move to the abyssal plain, often eroding and producing the characteristic canyons. Among many others, hydrocarbon and communication companies are very worried about these slope currents as they endanger their pipes and cables. Eventually, we reach the abyssal plains, huge regions with kilometers deep waters. Only the uppermost hundreds of meters of the water column are penetrated by light, making life possible. Below this zone, light is nearly absent and temperatures are low. A slow water movement and very little life.